Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I want to explain about some more numerical problems on coordinate geometry. The first problem in this video is, in which ratio does the point -4, 6 divide the line joining segments, the points A, -6, 10, B, 3, -8. That means here, AB points A, -6, 10, B, 3, -8 are there. One point is there here, suppose P, its coordinates given -4, 6. Now what he is asking is, this point in which ratio it is dividing this line joining. That means M1 is to M2. Before M1, M2 ratio you gave, we have calculated the coordinates of that point P. Now here the point gave, but that point in which ratio it is dividing the line AB is asking. The formula is same, but M1, M2 we have to find out. That point we have to equate this point already gave. That's why as usual with M1 is to M2 ratio, you write the coordinates formula. That coordinates equal to this one because coordinates given. Therefore by equating we will get the values, M1, M2 values. Now write, let A -6, 10, B 3, -8 are the given points. Let point P -4, 6 divides the line AB in the ratio M1 is to M2. Therefore, the coordinates of P are, we know that formula, M1 X2 plus M2 X1 by M1 plus M2 comma M1 Y2 plus M2 Y1 by M1 plus M2. This is the formula. Now here, x1 is equal to -6, x2 is equal to x1 -6, x2 3, y1 is equal to 10, y2 is equal to -8, m1 is to m1, that is ratio is m1 is to m2 only. Okay, you substitute now in this M1 only. M1 into X2 is 3 plus M2 X1 is -6 by M1 plus M2 comma, this is X coordinate. For Y coordinate, M1 Y2 is -8 plus M2 Y1 is 10 by M1 plus M2. First you simplify this one. 3M1 minus 6M2 by M1 plus M2 comma minus 8M1, see, multiply minus 8M1 plus 10M2 by M1 plus M2. So this is X coordinate, this is Y coordinate, but given coordinates of P is equal to -4, 6. So that's why these are the P coordinates. We also calculated P coordinates. These two are equal. This is according to formula, this is given. So these two are equal means what? The X coordinate equal to X coordinate, Y coordinate equal to Y coordinate. By taking any one, we can solve. This also we can take. This Y coordinate equate to 6 or this X coordinate equal to 4. Anyway, you can solve. I am taking first one. Therefore 3M1 minus 6M2 by M1 plus M2 is equal to this X coordinate is equal to this. If you are taking Y coordinate, you equate to 6. I took X1 coordinate. That's why the X1 coordinate is 4 means 4 by 1. Cross multiplication, -4 into m1 plus m2 is equal to only 1 into 3m1 minus 6m2. Now minus 4m1, this is also minus, minus into plus minus, 4m2 is equal to 3m1 only minus 1 6m2, 6m2 only. M1's one side, m2 one side take. Minus 4m1, this m1 come to this side, minus 3. 4m1, this come to this side, minus 3m1 is equal to, see here, this side, minus 6m2, this come to this side, plus 4m2. Now see, minus 7m1 is equal, both are minus, add. This is minus, so plus, minus is more, so minus, so 2m2. Now minus minus cancel, both sides there. So 7m1 is equal to 2m2. Therefore m1 by m2, we want ratio, that's why m1 by m2 is equal to 2 by 7. M1 by m2 equal to this side, this come to this side. Therefore m1 is to m2 is equal to 2 is to 7. Therefore the point divides point P divides line AB in the ratio 2 is to 7. So m1 m2 values we got, that's why the point P, the P divides AB into 2 is to 7 ratio. Okay, direct substitution only, but m1 m2 is asking, so that's why you equate any one of the x coordinate or y coordinate. The next sum is, if the points A 6, 1, B 8, 2, C 9, 4, D P, 3 are the vertices of a parallelogram taken in order. Find P. See, in one of the point, the variable he gave P. But these are vertices of a parallelogram. So, using that parallelogram properties, we should find out the value of P. So, how can you find out? We will see here. First, you draw a rough parallelogram. Suppose this is a parallelogram, this is one diagonal, this is another diagram. I am taking here A, A is 6, 1, B 8, 2 in order. So in order, C, C point 9, 4, D point P, 3. These are the points given in order. These two diagonals intersected at O. Now see. How can you find out this value of P? By using parallelogram properties. What are the parallelogram properties? Opposite sides are equal. Diagonals are not equal. Suppose opposite sides are equal. That means opposite side what? AD, BC. In this AD, this variable is there. In this, all points are there. That's why find the distance between AD and find the distance between BC to equate it. We will get the point P. Otherwise, this side, opposite sides equal means this also equal to this. So, CD distance you calculate, AB distance you calculate, both you equate because both are equal lengths, so opposite sides. From that equation also we will get P. So, in those two methods, any method we can get P. But, that is some difficult methods. Why? Because the distance between two parallel is what? X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. So, that is lengthy formula. And square roots also there. We have to squaring both sides again like that. Some process is there. But another simple method is what means. That is another property of the parallelogram is parallelogram bisects the diagonals. Parallelogram bisects the diagonals. The diagonals intersect each other in parallelogram. That means what? AC and DB are there. They are bisecting means what? They bisect. That means the pointers. Point of intersection is such that OD is equal to OB and OA is equal to OC. This diagonal also bisect, that means OA is equal to OC. this diagonal also bisect. That means OD is equal to OB, like that. Equal means we know midpoint. So this is the midpoint. That's why the midpoint of AC is O, the midpoint of BD is O. Both is O. That's why you calculate the midpoint of AC. That is simple. Midpoint means x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. There is no square roots and not lengthy formula. Very simple formula. X1 plus x2 by 2. Midpoint formula. Y1 plus y2 by 2. So like that, for this midpoint calculate, that is O. For this also midpoint calculate, that is O. In both sides, O. Though both you equate. Because the midpoint of this point only, the midpoint of this point, both is O only. Those two midpoints you equate means the variable P will get by from that equation. That is easy. Now, take that process. Now, let A, 6, y, 6, 1, B, 8, 2, C, 9, 4, D, P, 3 are the vertices of a parallelogram, ABCD, ABCD. Next, let O be the point of intersection of the diagonals DB, AC. We know diagonals intersect, diagonals bisect each other. In parallelogram, diagonals intersect each other, I told you. Therefore, that is meaning what? OA is equal to OC, OD is equal to OB. Therefore, O is the midpoint of BD, CA. For both, this is midpoint. Now calculate midpoint of only midpoint for both the line segments. So midpoint of first calculate BD. Midpoint of BD. X1 is equal to, for this, X1 is equal to P, X2 is equal to 8 points, Y1 is equal to 3, Y2 is equal to 2. For these points you write X1, Y1, X2, Y2 points. P8, 3, 2. Okay. Now midpoint formula is what? X1 X2 by 2, comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2. In this you substitute these values. X1 is P plus X2 is 8 by 2, comma Y1 is 3 plus Y2 is 2 by 2. So this is P plus 8 by 2, 5 by 2. That's it. Now midpoint of AC. Now you write for AC, X1 is 6, X2 you write. X1 is 6, X2 is 9, Y1 is 1, Y2 is 4. Therefore, point X1 plus X2 by 2, Y1 plus Y2 by 2. That means X1 is 6 plus X2, 9 by 2, comma Y1 plus Y2, 1 plus 4 by 2. This is what? 15 by 2, this is 6 plus 9, 15 by 2, this is 5 by 2. Okay? This is midpoint of AC. This is midpoint of BD. But midpoint of AC and BC same. O. This is also O. This is also O. Same. That's why these two we equate. So P plus 8 by 2, comma 5 by 2. This is midpoint of AC. That is O. This is also midpoint of BD. This is also O. Both are equal only. See, this is equal only number because number. But this is variable. That's why we should equate to find the value of P. Now, cross multiplication. 2 into P plus 8 is equal to 2 15s 30. So, P plus 8 is equal to 30, this come to this side, to 15. P plus 8 is equal to 15 means P is equal to 15, this come to this side, 7. Therefore, P is equal to 7. Therefore, the value of P is equal to 7. What he asked that find P, the value of P is equal to 7. So this is midpoint means some easy. Otherwise, very lengthy formula. I hope everyone understood this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.